Stand by for action.
Thanks for joining me. My name is Dave Milner. I am the Unpleasant Blind Guy, and I want to welcome you to part 3 of this episode of the Unpleasant Blind Guy on EDL Radio. Now remember, if you want to contact me with comments, questions, show suggestions, Awesome American suggestions, I'm available at UBG Contact on Twitter, or I can also be found as Dave Milner or Agador, that's A-G-G-E-D-O-R, on Mublet, the Tea Party Community, Spreely, Minds, MeWe, or Gab. Now let's begin.
Egghead, dude. Welcome back to the English Defense
Radio
Show with your host, Jeff Blue Doggy Mitchell.
Magic. No, brilliant, Dave.
All right. Well, Jeff, you know what? That's my fault, man. I was muted, and I didn't realize I was because I was looking at this, and I was looking at that and whatnot, and I apologize to the listeners.
No, it's all right. Dave, but we're over time that I normally do, so I'm glad I realized, oh, I better call in. We've got another gentleman joined us this evening, David Williams. Good to see you, David, and good to see you
joined us
this evening.
Welcome. Jeff, as I was saying, I was on there muted. The mic works really well when you turn it on. But I was stupidly on here saying, hey Jeff, you don't want to call back in? I got a tune I could play. You know, I found a quick one. You know. Anyway, we're back, folks. Yeah,
nah, it's all good. David says thanks, guys. He's just acknowledged. You know, what just said so. No, it's all good, Dave, because it gave me a chance
to actually look
at the clock and think, oh my goodness me, I've gone over my time that I said I was going to call in. You know, because I got so involved. But I think the last thing I did say to you, Dave, is what would happen if we maybe, you know, people dressed up in the full burka, the full ninja outfit, Dave?
What sort of
response would we get from the Sharia? Encroachment. Do you know what that? Encroachment officers. How would they respond, Dave?
No, Jeff, as I said, you know, when I was stupidly muted, no, I think that would be a very, very fascinating demonstration. And I think that some people might want to look at and think about doing, because I think it would make a heck of a point, man. I really do. I think it's a great idea. See, there's a reason,
guys, why Jeff
is the captain of this ship over here.
I have heard it has been talked about. That's all. Because if we've got something going on, loose lips sphincter. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, whoever's listening, we could just be winding you up. Do you know what I'm saying? You know, misinformation, you know, that they do to us all the time, Dave. We could.
Of course,
we keep winding you in a bit. You know what we're saying, guys? Yeah. It works both ways, you see. You know, you can play dirty with us like you had done for such a long time. But you know what? We could do something very similar. So, there you go. Wind it in, guys. Wind it in. Yeah. Like a fishing line, isn't it? There you go.
a little bit of fishing. Well, yeah, exactly. Now, Jeff, our final story, this may not be our final story. We may be able to get one more in after this one, but let's try this one. In the slides, you see FBI headquarters here in the United States, and my deep state policing thing. Okay, this story came out on August the 1st, and it has generated a lot of speculation in various real media platforms. Okay, and we wanted to talk about it here because this is definitely a first-class threat to free speech. The one that I've got, this comes from several places, but the one that I'm using is from the New York Post. This was put out, by the way, by Yaron Steinberg. Yeah. And this is FBI conspiracy theory, quote, extremists, end quote, are a terror threat. Okay. So now if you talk about anything that some shadowy unelected official considers a conspiracy theory, you're now a terrorist threat, according to this report from the FBI. And I'm just positioning this now to where I can read it. Okay, here we go. The FBI has, for the first time, identified conspiracy theory-driven domestic extremists as a terror threat, including the believers in the shadowy QAnon network, according to a report. Okay, this, so far, guys, all this is just a report. This isn't established law or anything, but they can definitely use this to make more established law. Now, an FBI bulletin, okay, that's where this comes from, dated May the 30th of this year, from the Bureau's Phoenix field office and obtained by Yahoo quote-unquote news, describes the growing threat and lists multiple arrests tied to violent incidents sparked by fringe beliefs. Okay, so they're really trying to push this hard. And you guys, you noticed this week during all of the garbage that went on involving these two shootings. Okay, the FBI assesses these conspiracy theories very likely will emerge, spread, and evolve in the modern information marketplace, occasionally driving both groups and individual extremists to carry out criminal or violent acts, the document states. All right, the feds believe the conspiracy theory extremists will likely increase their activities during the 2020 presidential election cycle, according to a document cited by Yahoo. You think? Couldn't have anything to do with the fact that I think his first name is Jeffrey Epstein. Was just found imitating a carcass in a slaughterhouse, hanging in a cell. But I digress. To continue, the Bureau said another factor driving the mounting threat is the uncovering of real conspiracies or cover-ups involving illegal, harmful, or unconstitutional activities by government officials or leading police figures. Now, what that says to me, guys, is that these things are happening, and they're saying that it's just making the matters worse. Well, no wonder people are believing in these things. All right, the FBI does not specify which people or cover-ups it was referring to. So even they're admitting this stuff goes on, people. The document specifically mentions the infamous QAnon conspiracy, which I have to tell you guys, this is the first place I've ever heard of it, whose believers say a deep state of Hollywood celebs and Democrats is working to undermine President Trump and is running an international pedophile ring, including Clinton associates from a D.C. pizzeria. So they're trying to put this on Pizzagate, and that's really what this is about. But anyway, news about the intelligence bulletin comes as the FBI faces pressure to explain whom it deems to be an extremist and how the government prosecutes domestic terrorists. That's right, the nub of it. All right. And we're going to look at this here. Okay, Jeff, I think that leaves us plenty of time to speculate. I'm not going to read any more about that story. You can go to the New York Post and find it for yourselves if you want.
It's open to debate over the issues, but I think anybody that has any common sense has studied, and we know exactly what's been going on. Pizzagate does exist. It's existed. I mean, all the things you were talking about, I was just nodding my head, Dave, because it's nothing to do with conspiracy, because it's happening. It's the truth. It's things are going on. But they try to make it as though it's conspiracy theories. I mean, it's just, this is how, you know, you feed disinformation. Try to confuse the issues. Is that what we're seeing here, Dave? Trying to confuse the truth?
There you go, Jeff. It is.
Yeah.
It is. Look at that. Yeah, I mean, look, you know, that's the thing. They're trying to confuse issues, because at the same time, in the same article, and I'm assuming in the same report, they said that there were and have been real conspiracies and cover-ups involving government officials and top police officials. So this stuff is going on, just as you say, and all they're trying to do is use this to shut people up and make them not talk about these things. What happens
over
here? Well,
they start
the
calling you domestic terrorists because you discuss it. Is this what they're trying to bring about?
Well, okay,
I'm
explaining that. Yeah, I'm explaining that, Jeff. What happens over here in the States, guys, is someone doesn't just stand up in Congress and say, well, we ought to have a law. They try to bring proofs that there ought to be a law. And in this case, you're talking about lefties wanting to shut people on the right up. So what they'll do is they'll bring this FBI report up, and they'll say, see, the FBI said that people who talk about these conspiracy theories are potential terrorists. So we have to legally shut them up and make it to where we can put them in jail if they say something we don't like. The one thing that they don't say, though, is who is going to make those decisions about what's a conspiracy theory, what's the truth, and who is going to go to jail because they break these laws. I mean, you're talking again about selective prosecution. The same thing that's going on right now, Jeff, in the United Kingdom is going on with this, man.
Bring it to the forefront will be deep state players. That's who will bring up prosecuting the deep state. And I do mean both sides of the pond, Dave. I mean
the
United Kingdom. I mean, that's why the deep state decided that Tommy Robinson was too much of a threat, causing too much. People were taking to what Tommy's saying, and the numbers are growing, and they think they're trying to stem the flow of the tsunami that Tommy has set off across the globe, and it's not going away.
No, it's not.
Dave,
it's
not. Just how I wanted to just sum it up.
You're right, man. You're right.
Yeah.
You're right, brother. You are absolutely right. It's the same on both sides of the pond, and it is the ongoing attempt on the part of the left to shut up the right, to create a world where our countries and our peoples are just a part of a big United Nations gulag that everybody has to live in. And it's something that we have to fight tooth and nail every step of the way. The United while Jeff and I are on vacay, one of the shows you're going to hear is an expose of the FBI and its involvement with Islam, and even talking about some of the big players that have been involved in this anti-Trump conspiracy, which is very real. You're going to hear that, so do tune in to this program when it's supposed to be on 8:30 p.m. in the UK and 3:30 p.m. Eastern in the United States, Thursdays and Sundays. You're going to get some great shows, including those while we're away. And Jeff, I have one more. I think you're going to like this one, man. I really do. I know. I love this one, brother.
Whenever Dave says things like that, I don't know if it's sort of for me to all of a sudden I'm going to explode of what's being said. I don't know, Dave, or whether it's just going to make me laugh. Go ahead, brother.
Well, I think this might make you explode with a little bit of pride, Jeff. That this is really awesome, and we've been holding this one back a little bit. This is from Alexander Robertson for the Mail Online. All right, this was updated on the 23rd of July. So we've had this one out for a while. I saw this as I was looking for other stories, and I thought, man, that is just friggin' awesome. The headlines on this one is hundreds of strangers turn out for separate funerals of two World War II veterans who died aged 101 and 93 with no surviving family. That's the headline. It is fantastic, man. There's three bullet points. The first one, RAF veteran Harold Tracy and former Welsh Guardsman Charles Saunders honored at ceremonies today. The second one, appeals were launched for strangers to attend both funerals amid concerns that nobody would attend either. And the last one, hundreds of strangers arrived to pay their respects to two war heroes in Shropshire and Broadstairs in Kent. How fantastic is that, my friend?
Well, moving, it's definitely, you know, it's good to see that good people, you know, want to say goodbye to some of our heroes, you know, who they wouldn't have expected so many people to be there. What a great send-off to two wonderful gentlemen. It just moves me, you know. You know, the big respect to those, everybody that turned up. God bless you. Thank you, guys. Wonderful.
Oh, absolutely.
Thank you for that, mate.
Oh, yeah, man. I mean, it's always nice to end a show with a story like that that just uplifts your spirits. It shows people, I mean, my God, the stuff we do here on this show, it just makes you think that almost everybody in the world is a complete a-hole. And to have something like this happen and have hundreds of people show their true hearts, it shows that there are truly good people left in the world who are willing to do the right thing. Jeff,
thanks. I've got to thank you for that. It lifts the heart and the soul when you hear a story like that, doesn't it, Dave? I mean, there's so much negative stuff out there, but this is, I don't know, it just makes you feel good in yourself when you see good people turning up to pay respect to two old gentlemen. Lovely to see that. And Dave, I've got to apologise. I'm having a few typing issues, so Gary, it was supposed to be, thank you for the link, Gary, appreciate it, but it turned out I said something like, thank you, Gary, for the link, appreciate it. And my apologies, I've got my computer doesn't light up on his screen, and I'm not the best typist in the world. So sorry, Gary, it wasn't, you know, it wasn't meant to happen, but it did, and I thought, oh no. So I just wanted to let you know. But Dave, thank you for that story, brother. Appreciate it.
Well, you know, it is nice to put out a feel-good story like that to end a show. And Jeff, it's been, I think we can begin at least with final thoughts. It has been a good show. And what all this just shows you, as far as this copper goes, and as far as the FBI goes, and as far as everything else goes, is that we still have a lot of work to do. We do. We're gonna be here to do it. You know,
the whole thing. I mean, week in, week out. I mean, when we're not on vacation, because today we, as Dave was sharing with you great listeners out there, we're taking a short break just to charge our batteries for the
couple of weeks
that we'll do before the end of the year. That's what we do. In fact, when we return, it's not too long. I think we return on the 4th, which is Sunday, and we will show
the
next show that we do.
Yeah.
We will be doing a special presentation of 9/11. I mean, that's it. So we're very...
Oh, yeah, man.
Once again, Dave, we're coming up to that.
Yeah.
That event
time
that changed the world.
Mm-hmm.
It's just unbelievable.
Yeah.
Where the so many years have gone by, but it's just like a blink of an eye. We remember every detail, every single thing that day, and live in our memories forever. And I just wanted to say that day, when we return, myself and Dave will get very together busy, and we will we'll do a bit of a special, won't we, Dave, for that show? You know.
Well, it will happen.
Possible. We might even come in. It might be a day before, but if we come in on the 11th or whatever day that's going to fall on, we'll do a special. I've talked about it today. Dave's looking and he's scratching. Are we? You know. No, I haven't talked about it today, but I thought I'd share that with you, ladies and gentlemen. But me and Dave will get busy together and, you know, we'll do something rather special. Am I right, Dave?
Well, we might, you know. Now, what's interesting, Jeff, here, I'm looking at the calendar, is the 11th falls on a Wednesday, okay? We might either do a show, a 9/11 show on that Thursday, I'm thinking, or we might do one on Sunday the 8th, either one. You know, we can talk about this, we'll speculate about it, but yeah, I mean, yeah. You know, we're going to come back on Thursday the 5th, guys. That's when we'll come back after the vacation, and our final show will be on the 18th of this month, and then we'll come back on Thursday the 5th, okay? And then we have another show to do on Sunday the 8th. That might be the 9/11 show. Who knows? Or we might do one on the 12th. It really depends. But we will, you know, Jeff and I will get together. We'll have a, you know, we'll have a talk about which one of those we want to do.
The way I look at it, we might do something a little bit different. You know, we might come in on that day. We might do it for that day on the 11th. But then again, look, ladies and gentlemen, we're talking about things that we discuss in between shows. Am I right, Dave?
I'll throw
it out there, guys. We will do something a little bit special. Anyway, yeah, it's got to be done.
Well, we'll see. We'll see, man. You know, I mean, that's a vacation away, Jeff. You know, I tell you, man, we do try to do things for people that that are sometimes a little bit different, but still, you know, keep you guys informed, and we try to be respectful of these big events. And I just want to say, finally, I'll throw it in. Please check out the Unpleasant Blind Guy page at Spreaker.com. My normal show times are 1 p.m. In Eastern in the United States, and that is 6 p.m. In the UK, Monday through Friday. And I do a show on Saturday at midnight Eastern in the United States, and that is 5 a.m. in the UK. And so please check that out. That comes out through there. It also comes out through the SHR Media YouTube page, and I'm also heard on the Western Free Radio Network. And again, for you guys listening, at the Unpleasant Blind Guy page at Spreaker.com. This program here is podcast live at 8:30 p.m. in the UK and at 3:30 p.m. Eastern in the United States, Thursdays and Sundays. So please come and join us for that. Jeff, it really has been a really good and a fantastic show, except for when I stupidly muted my mic.
Give me a chance to call in, Dave. I'm glad that whatever happened, it was meant to happen. You know.
There you go.
No, don't worry about that, Dave. It was you were brilliant as usual. Got to thank you once again, Dave, for the great slides, the scripting, and everything. So thanks for all the work you do. And I'm thinking about Jan, and a big salute to you, darling.
Oh yeah, love you, Jan.
You know, when she can, she'll join us, and she's a wonderful lady, isn't she, Dave?
Yes,
Dave, was there anything else that you just wanted to fish up? Because I've got a couple of things that David was mentioning, so I'll hope to just fit there. Dave, I will be speaking about couple of things that you just put there before we close the show. So, Dave, if there's anything else that you needed to share with our listeners before I just read my final thoughts for the evening.
Just one more thing, Jeff. I just want to say to the foot soldiers, angels, Brexiteers, and global patriots out there, be prosperous, be blessed, and no surrender. Back to you, brother. I'm going to throw it at you. Catch it.
And no surrender ever, Dave. Thank you, mate, as usual. But before I go on to say good night to everybody that's listening to the broadcast this evening, I'd like to say this is what David Williams is saying. He said, there are lots of good people in the world. Sadly, the ones running the world seem to be always evil. And he goes on to say, it seems a perquisite. I've pronounced that right. He also goes on to say, because I didn't see that coming, actually. He said regarding Epstein, he was suicided exactly, listen to this, Dave, exactly 33 days after his first court appearance on July the 8th. His main accuser is a 33-year-old. He was 66 times 2 times 33. And the first attack he suffered was on the 24th of July, exactly 18 days after his arrest, on the 6th of July. That's, listen to this, Dave, this is what jumped out at me. That's three sixes hidden in his plain view, guys. So there you go. Wow. Mm. Thank you, David. And my goodness me, it just jumps out. What David said, he's so right. Thank you very much for that, David. And Gary, Gary's thanking us all. Thank you, gents. Never, ever surrender. Never surrender, ever. That's right, Gary. That we will never, mate. So, but once again, David, that's why I like having you here, buddy. Everything's put together. What he said there, isn't that amazing, Dave? I didn't even think about those figures, actually, what Dave was saying. How about that, Dave?
Amazing stuff, Jeff, definitely.
It certainly is. And with that, oh my God, we've got 4 minutes, but I've got to thank everybody. Dave Williams, of course, Gary Kempner. Thank you for the link, Gary. I will check that out. And when I've done the show, he's dropped a great link in here. So for myself, from Dave, of course, Jan, my executive producers, Charlie and Bluey. And everybody out there, of course, our mate, great media team for the English Defence League, .org.uk. Please visit that website, ladies and gentlemen. You know, we appreciate everything, any donation. We got a donate page, you know, PayPal took our donate, but we got another one up there going. So, you know, it's everything you put towards us. It's really, really appreciated. So thank you so much for anybody who has. So from myself and Dave, from everybody associated with the English Defence League Radio Show and the great organisation, we'll see you again this Thursday. No surrender. I almost played Percy the Patriotic Pigeon. Dave almost hit the button on that. What am I like? Anyway, we're going underground. Take it away, guys. there you go. I'd say once again, that's an end of a live broadcast. Now we've just gone into the archive part of the show. Got to thank everybody. Now, once again, it's interesting. We could have two great gentlemen in the chat this evening. I say Gary Kemper and Darby Williams, and some very interesting things said there. So thanks, guys. Hope to see you both Thursday this week. So with that, ladies and gentlemen, we'll be back again. I say this Thursday with another show. Probably a lot more stories coming through on our desk as we talk. And we'll see you again this Thursday. So, just to say, this is the English Defence League radio show, signing off for tonight, and from myself and Dave, we'll see you again this Thursday. Good night, God bless. And guys, just as I say, just be vigilant out there. Just be aware of your environment around you, you know. We just want to keep you safe, guys. That's all it is. Just keep you safe. Good night. God bless. No surrender. No surrender ever. Good night.
And that is it for this time. I appreciate each and every one of you. Thank you for listening. And may your God go with you. Goodbye. The Unpleasant Blind Guy is copyright 2019. Anno Domini. Now for Dave's Canes. Extras that help you navigate the new media world.
Conservative media done right. You're listening to the SHR Media Network.
Hey, this is Michael Wright.
And I'm Shannon Wright.
Join us for The Right Way with Shannon and Mike, Monday through Thursday from 7 to 9 a.m. right here on SHR Media.
Why are they joining us?
For fun things like sports, politics.
Oh, maybe some news and entertainment?
And all kinds of other things.
Money and recipes and events, all kinds of stuff.
Yeah, so join us Monday through Thursday, 7 to 9 a.m. here on SHRmedia.com.
From a public locker inside a dilapidated Long Island rail station comes a show designed to piss off liberals using truth, facts, and ridicule. The Lid Radio Show, featuring the conservative voice from the People's Republic of New York. The Lid himself, Jeff Dunitz. Tune in every Wednesday at 2 p.m. Eastern, 11 a.m. Pacific on the SHR Media Network. Go to shrmedia.com. At Lid Radio, we fight for the truth, justice, and a good kosher T-bone. If you don't listen, Hillary Clinton might sneak into your bedroom in her house coat late at night and blame you for her election loss. It's the Lid Radio Show with Jeff Dunitz.
It's Your Business Diva here, Melanie Collette. I am inviting you to a front row seat as I discuss some of the most intriguing details of wealth and finance with today's movers and shakers in the world of business. Listen in and discover financial truths on a global, domestic, and household scale. Uncover topics that will impact your wallet today and in the future. Money Talk with Melanie airs Monday through Friday, 5 p.m. East, 2 p.m. West, right here on SHR Media and High Plains Pundit Talk Radio. You can't afford to miss it.
The new show on the SHR Media Network, Sackheads Against Tyranny, on shrmedia.com. Go there quick like a bunny, 11 p.m. Eastern, 8 p.m. Pacific, every Wednesday, live and direct on the SHR Media Network, shrmedia.com. Be there.
Broadcasting behind enemy lines in occupied California, a mere 2 miles from the state capital, the Bloviating Zeppelin's Berserk Bobcat Saloon Radio Show can be heard every Tuesday and Thursday night at 8 p.m. Pacific and 11 p.m. Eastern, only on the SHR Media Network. Go to shrmedia.com to listen. You can also watch on the SHR Media Facebook page and the SHR Media YouTube channel. No goldfish were abused in the making of this ad.
Hey girls, Carry Girl Gear is here. More and more women every day are concealed carrying, participating in competitive shooting, and getting firearms training. It's not a boys' club anymore, and we don't have to shop in their stores anymore either. Finally, a cool and unique clothing line just for women. Dope tees and hats for the patriotic concealed carry and 2A girl. So what are you waiting for? Go check out carrygirlgear.com today.
Conservative media done right. You're listening to the SHR Media Network.